You know, they say starting is the biggest step, so you made the right decision. But before we can start, we need to go over a few things you need in order to follow along with the webinar. Below this video is a breakdown with any tutorials or links you may need to get started for each item. So feel free to pause the video when you need to complete this step, and let's get through this so we can jump into the webinar. And before I forget, we are going to be using some templates and placeholders as we get started. So if you don't have a logo, icon, your tagline, or any content for that matter, don't worry, because you can work on that later if you need to. For now, the first thing you will need is a working email address. You need this for a few things. Directly below this video is a form to subscribe to the webinar updates. This is where I'll send you any updates or additional tutorials you may need moving forward after the webinar. Look, I hate spam and only use this for weekly updates and needed communications to keep you in the loop. So please don't forget to sign up so you don't miss any of those emails. You're also going to use your email to register your domain and sign up for other accounts. Now, there is a very good chance that you already have an email address, but if you don't, I do have a tutorial link below to help you sign up for a free Gmail account. The second thing, and one of the most important, is a secure password. When you sign up for some of these different accounts, they control your website and ultimately your reputation online. Without a secure password, you risk being vulnerable to hacks. And if your website is your main source of business, you also could risk losing everything. So be sure you have a secure password. If you need it, I've put together some training that includes a keyword strength checker that will blow your mind. The next item on the list is a working credit card. We discussed the $120 cost in the intro video, and that's what this is for. We will cover most of those steps inside of the webinar, but we will be covering the page builder before we start, but more on that in a little bit. Now we need to talk about a massive mistake that a lot of people make when getting started: naming your business. Okay, it's not really naming a business as much as it is the brand or handle that your business uses online. When I started my first digital marketing agency, I found a name that I loved. I bought the domain, wrote the content, designed the website, made a logo, ordered business cards, and a bunch of other stuff, only to get a cease and desist because the name was trademarked by a firm in New York. I was given 7 days to take everything down, yet all of this could have been avoided by doing a basic trademark search. Of course, there's more to finding a good username, like making sure you can get the .com domain, checking availability on social media. This can take some time, but if you follow along with the training link below, I'll cover everything you need to know. Once you have a unique username, you will then need a logo. You can use software to design it yourself, or you can hire a designer. There are many different options linked in the training. If you need it, please take advantage of it. For the website, we will need a PNG or transparent logo file that is no more than 360 pixels wide. Moving down the list, the next thing we have is your website icon. This is the image that shows up in the tabs of your browser, and it is also used on smartphones when your visitors add your website to their home screen. The image should be a 512 pixel square image. In the icon link, I have a free template for you if you need it. And while we have a section in the webinar for your tagline, I know it's something that evolves over time, especially when you're starting out. If you already have one, great. If you don't worry. Like I said before, you can go through the training later and update your site when the time is right. Let's discuss your content. This can be prepped before you start with the webinar, or you can use placeholders and work on your content along the way. Don't worry if you're not a writer, because there are ghostwriters that can take some basic information from you and turn it into amazing content for your website. I've listed a link below to an evolving blog post designated to your overall website content. The information on the link is extremely detailed and links out to many other blog posts and training, but we will cover the basics inside the webinar. Last thing we are going to need before the webinar is a license for the page builder we are going to use. It's called Elementor, and there are two parts to it: the free version, which gives you the basic framework, and the pro version, which allows you to basically build and design your own WordPress theme with its custom theme builder. This is how we are going to design our header and footer. It also comes with an amazing form builder for your contact page, And moving forward after the webinar, I'll show you how you can use it to build your list and a bunch of other stuff. To get your licensed copy of Elementor Pro, all you need to do is go to buyprolink.com. Once you are there, just click on pricing in the header and buy your license. You only need the personal license unless you plan on designing other websites, then choose accordingly. Once you have completed the purchase, you're ready to get started. So let's get started. Click on the button below to start the webinar, and I'll see you inside.